to Carmel Green, the story about how Carmel is actually becoming greener by the minute. If you stay tuned, I'm going to show you some great information about a new program here at Carmel Utilities. My name is Jeff Worrell, and joining me today is the director of Carmel Utilities, Mr. John Duffy. Welcome.
Hi, Jeff. Thank you.
Welcome to Carmel Green. Man, that is a mantra for you guys. You are all about green. We're here to talk about a new program called your Biosolids Program.
Correct.
Can you give me, for our viewers, the real quick definition of what we're doing here with the Biosolids Program?
What we do with our biosolids here, biosolids, another term meaning sludge,
okay.
We basically are heating it and creating a product in the end that is certified that homeowners can come get it. They can be used in gardens. It could actually be marketed and sold. We're taking a product that used to go to a landfill in many cases and doing something, we're reusing it basically.
Yeah, I think let's make that point. Let's be clear that we are actually taking something that used to be a drain on the environment and you're actually helping the environment. Now, is my understanding, what used to go to the landfill, you're now using this process behind us, we're gonna get into that,
right.
But you're making it a product that eventually could be sold someday.
Correct.
It's that good.
Correct, it's a great soil conditioner. We actually have a permit from the state to market it and sell it if we could. We've considered bagging it up, and actually we have bagged it and have given some away at the farmer's market.
Yeah, so now let's talk about the process behind us. My understanding is that's called biopasteur.
Right.
And what is happening here, there's only two of these systems in the United States.
Correct.
Carmel being system number one.
Correct.
We were copied, obviously, by all, and we'll be copied for years to come, I'm sure. But what's happening here? What is going on back here?
Basically, what we're doing, we bring the sludge into a holding tank. It goes through something that chops it up, even makes it finer.
Yeah.
And we use water. We heat up a water with boiler, and it's a heat exchanger, and we heat it up to a temperature requirement that we have to meet. From there, it goes into the tanks you see, and it's a pasteurization process in that it's stored.
Like my milk?
Like your milk, exactly.
Okay.
From there, and we have to store it there, for about a half hour, roughly 150 degrees temperature.
Yeah.
From there, it goes into our anaerobic digesters, which are a closed lid, and the biological process continues there where pathogen removal and other things go on. And we produce methane gas. It's an off gas from that.
Yeah.
And we actually are reusing the methane gas to run the boiler, which heats the water.
Okay, so now let's be clear. We're here at 96th and Hazeldale. Mm-hmm. Everyone has seen the big flame.
Right.
And that is just the excess, but you're actually using most of the methane,
right,
to operate the boilers here.
Correct. We use the methane to heat the water up. And we also, additionally, take it and transfer that heat over to our maintenance building. In the wintertime, we heat that building with that methane gas. And one other thing we do that you'll see later on is we actually supplement our solar dryer with that heat.
Okay.
As well.
And we're going to talk about that next.
Right.
But I just want to be clear, what's going on here is taking the sludge,
right,
and when we've talked about this on Connecting with Carmel, I think you and I've talked about it, but
right,
we're making a Class A biosolid that is,
right,
actually, in the next step that we're going to talk about, is going to make it better than Class A.
Correct, yeah, it's Class A special, I guess.
Well, in my world, it's better than Class A.
Right.
I think it's A+. What do you guys think, huh? A+? All right, so Carmel's got A+ sludge. Why don't we head over to the other part of the process and fill everyone in. You ready?
Yes, sir.
Let's do it.
Thanks.
We're here in front of the solar dryer. And they challenged me to pick up some of, what do we call this again?
Biosolid.
I have another name
Carmel
for it.
Carmel Green.
I have another name for it, and it's not Carmel Green. But I've got it in my hand, but we're actually here in front of the solar dryer. This is what it looks like. I am holding it in my hand, and I guess it's actually okay.
Yes.
I was a little nervous, I will admit, but it's okay. And this is what we're trying to get to. It starts out with something that's very gunky and
wet,
what,
hard
wet,
to work with.
And what used to go to the landfill and was a drain,
right,
on the environment, you now are turning it into something I can hold in my hand.
Right.
You want some?
Sure.
All right, I'll share it with you.
Right.
I'm gonna get rid of this. Okay, so we've got Carmel Green, and this is what it ends up being. And the whole idea, the reason that you,
right,
started this was mainly to?
Just take our biosolid, and rather than having it go to a landfill, People can reuse it, farmers can use it, the public can reuse it for planting tomatoes, growing grass. And it's a great soil conditioner.
Okay, now sneaking up behind us is Lisa, right? She is the mole. I'm hoping they can get a shot of Lisa. Now tell us a little bit about what Lisa's job is.
When we put the Class A product in here, we're trying to dry it even further to make it workable.
Yeah.
And what Lisa does is goes through and turns the soil, the product over to make sure it dries uniformly.
Okay.
And it's basically a robot.
And she's churning it.
Correct.
And
right.
You lovingly have named her, and all the employees and the staff here keep an eye on Lisa and are right. Glad to have her as part of the team.
Yep. We can actually view it remotely, and Lisa does her thing.
Yeah.
And does a real good job.
Kind of looks like a Volkswagen. So, all right. Now we've got the cost of this. How much money are we saving, do you think? You know, obviously there was some infrastructure, but now that it's an ongoing process, what are some of the economics?
It's approximately $100,000 a year we save.
Savings,
correct. Where we used to have to either take it to a landfill or we were able to haul to some farmers' fields.
You were trying to
be green. Right.
Yeah, but it was not real conducive scheduling and weather.
Difficult.
and transportation.
Right, and permitting issues. And it's costly, time-consuming, all those things.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
It's at least $100,000 a year that we're saving.
Okay, so this is an ongoing process. You're going to empty this. It will go to wherever you then take it to. Where is that? Where does it go to?
Currently, it's primarily going to sod farms where
okay.
they grow sod, and they are using it to grow their sod. And homeowners can come down here and get it if they like. They have to call ahead. But,
okay, we do ask that you call ahead just to make sure you have some.
Right.
I notice there's not a whole lot because you're going through it quite
correct.
A lot.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, and so then you'll fill this back up, and it's right. during the summer, it's about a 4-week, I think Teresa was telling me it's
right.
about a 4-week process.
It all depends on the weather, but it's in the summer, it's roughly about a 4-week
yeah.
process.
Okay.
Correct.
Okay, all right. Well, very good. Now, do you want to get rid of that?
Yeah.
All right, we're throwing it into the solar dryer. Go like this. We'll get the hand sanitizer, but no big deal, huh?
No, it's very safe to use.
And you won't go over there and grab a handful of that other stuff, will you?
I would, but it's more messy.
Well, I'm not. So, I'm not. Okay. All right. No, that was about as far as I'll go. So, all right. Well, thank you for joining us for this edition of Carmel Green. And John, I want to thank you.
Thank you.
John Duffy has joined us today to tell us all about the new Biosolids program here at Carmel, Indiana. And we're very proud of it. You are director of the Carmel Utilities.
Correct. Yep.
And you've been on the job now how long?
Since 1996.
So you watched this program, and any other neat things that you've got on the horizon, or the other things you're looking at? I know you're really trying to convert that methane gas. That's a
right.
big priority for you to
right.
use it more and more as you can.
We actually use a portion of the methane gas to heat our maintenance building.
Okay, so those are all initiatives
right.
you're trying to do in order to use
right.
that more.
And in the wintertime, we're using that methane gas to supplement the heat in the solar dryer
great.
To get it to dry even quicker.
All right, keep it up. All you folks out there that love being green, Carmel is helping you to be greener. So thanks to John Duffy, all the employees, all the staff to help you do this. I'm Jeff Worrell saying thanks for watching this edition of Carmel Green.